everyone, and today we are going to talk about Paleolithic diets.
The real Paleolithic diet wasn't all meat and marrow. It's true that hunter-gatherers around the world crave meat more than any other food and usually get around 30% of their annual calories from animals. But most also endure lean times, when they eat less than a handful of meat each week. New studies suggest that more than a reliance on meat in an ancient human diet fueled human brain expansion. Year-round observations confirm that hunter-gatherers often have dismal success as hunters. The Hadza and Kung bushmen of Africa, for example, fail to get meat more than half the time when they venture forth with bows and arrows. No one can eat meat all that often, except in the Arctic, where Inuit and other groups traditionally got as much as 99% of their calories from seals, narwhals and fish. So, how do hunter-gatherers get energy when there's no meat? It turns out that man the hunter is backed up by woman the forager, who with some help from children provides more calories during difficult times. When meat, fruit and honey are scarce, foragers depend on fallback foods. The Hadza get almost 70% of their calories from plants. The Kung traditionally rely on tubers and mangono nuts. In other words, there is no one ideal human diet. The real hallmark for being human beings isn't our taste for meat, but our ability to adapt to many habitats, and to be able to combine many different foods to create many healthy diets. Unfortunately, the modern Western diet does not appear to be one of them.